Unity Input System is a package that lets you configure game controls across multiple devices. It is intended to be a more powerful, flexible, and configurable replacement for the legacy input manager. You can set up from keyboard controls to game console controllers, and the best part is that it is easier to add control schemes in the future. In this video, you will learn to set up Unity's input manager and trigger custom events based on controller input. This video will also avoid the use of the singleton pattern and instead use Unity's scriptable objects. And with that, let's head over to Unity. First thing you need to do is to go to your package manager and install the input system package. Once it is installed, Unity will then prompt you to restart the application. Close the package manager and let's start setting up the input system. Right-click on the project panel and create an input action asset. Double-click on the input asset you've just created. Add an action map and name it based on what it's intended for. An action map is a data type that has a list of actions attached to it. It can be an action map for gameplay, UI screens, and so forth. We will only be focusing on the gameplay input in this video for now. Select the new action, and I'll explain the action types. Value is something that is used for things such as floats, vectors, and so on. Button is self-explanatory. Pass-through bypasses the disambiguation process unlike value actions. I have placed a link in the description if you'd like to read more. Select the value action type and set its control type to any. Click on the plus icon and select up, down, left, right composite and then name it according to the type of controller you will use. For binding, click on the path and type in the key you want to bind for that specific action. For controller setup, let's do something different this time. Select the path, then instead of typing out the bind key, click on the bar above it. It will then listen to an input key you will press and filter out the options. I have attached my game controller for this demo and the input system detects its information. For the modes, there is analog, digital normalized, and digital. Analog is best used when you want to use the tilt functionality of your controller. For digital normalized, it is the normalized value of your input action, mainly 0 to 1, while digital is self-explanatory. I've set my controller to use the analog mode while I left the keyboard as is. Click the plus icon near the action and let's set up some button input. I will leave the interactions and processors be for now as it might add some additional complexities when handling this topic. Just know that interaction is how you press the button and the processor is the math calculated associated with your input action. For the binding, I have set the space key for my keyboard input and button south for gamepad. Setting it this way will open up a lot of controller support later on, so keep this practice in mind. Save the asset, then close the input action tab. Click on the input action asset and let's generate the C# class for our player input. This will create a script that we can use in setting up our controller. Create a script that will serve as the input reader and let's head down to Visual Studio. The first thing I did was to remove the functions associated with mono behavior, then replaced it with the scriptable object base class. I then integrated our generated C# script interface. Remember this class and action map? That's our input action interface. I then implemented the interface for our input action events. Next, I added the system namespace, then created two action components that will serve as our event listeners. Speaking of event listeners, consider subscribing to my channel if you want to receive updates on my next video. I then applied said events in our interface methods and invoked them with respect to their contexts. Performed means that the button is pressed, while read value basically returns the vector position based on user input. More on this later. The last thing to do to complete this script is to create a player input component and set our input action callbacks into this scriptable object. Then, enable our gameplay action map to make it active when enabled. For implementation, I added the input reader component into our spawner script and subscribe our instancing method into our action event. For our movement, the implementation is the same with a slight difference. I removed the time.delta time in our movement calculation as it is deemed redundant and is already implemented into our input system by default. We can change the update mode into our input system package inside the project settings. Click on Create Settings Asset, then process your events however you like. I left it as is for now. Back in our scene, create your scriptable object asset and assign it to the controller fields. And that's pretty much it. If you'd like to know more on how I implemented scriptable objects, I have a video that will teach you the basics. Thanks for watching, like and follow for more.